Hi, this project is Madicine pills dispenser. So here this is the mechanism. So here we can perform two different kinds of pills. So I will explain how this mechanism is working. Initially these two is for dropping pills from here to here by using this mechanism. So how it is, we have to drop our pills into this tube, then it is coming here, then here there is one servo motor is there. So by Arduino it is moving like this. So then the pill which is here, it is coming from here to here and finally drops here. So like that it will work. So we can have the more than 10 to 20 pills in this tube, and one by one pills is coming from here to here by using this mechanism. And also this is moving from 0 degrees to 45 degrees. So these two, this is the structure. Like this we have two. And also coming to this, so this is microcontroller, the entire controlling circuit here. So how this is working, there is Atmega and Arduino mega controller is there. This is microcontroller and this is GSM module, this is Wi-Fi module, this is power supply circuit, this is 2 amps 5 volt circuit, this is RFID, LCD and battery power supply. So the basic operation of this project is we have to drop our pills into these two tubes, two different kinds of pills. Then here there are two kinds of different access. One is with RFID cards. These two are RFID cards. Whenever we swipe that card in front of this RFID reader, it can detect, and each card having 100 rupees balance. So after swiping our RFID card into RFID reader, then it is asking about selecting the pill type, whether pill 1 or pill 2. Here we are taking in pill 1, we are taking paracetamol, and in pill 2 we are taking saridone, two different kinds of pills. Then here we have a keypad. The keypad is here. So it has three switches. So by using this keypad we can enter our number of pills and the kind of pills and all. So generally while entering quantity of pill, we have to press increment, decrement and enter. When you press increment, it is incrementing from 0 to 9. So when we want to decrement number, then it is coming from 0 to 9, 9 to 0. So if you want to move to next digit, then we have to press enter. Like that we have to enter quantity. And also by using these three keys we can select pill type also, whether that is paracetamol or saridone, by using this. After swiping card into RFID reader, then we have to select pill type by using this keypad. After pill type, then it is asking quantity of number of pills. So then that is also we have to enter from this keypad. After that, if you select paracetamol and number of pills are 3, then 3 pills are coming from here to here automatically. Then that information is that same information is going to SMS by using this GSM module, and the same information is going to IoT server, that is ThingSpeak server, by this Wi-Fi module ESP8266. Actually, I will show you how this data format is coming in SMS. Here there are sample SMS, like see this SMS, there is saridone and card 1, quantity is 2 and balance is 98. Here all information is there, that means whether the type of pill, whether saridone or paracetamol, and which card we are using. Generally we can use multiple cards, but here we have two cards. Then here among these two cards we are using card 1, and the quantity of pills are 2. And also here the each pill cost is 1 rupee. By default each card has 100 rupees. If 2 pills are coming out, then that means our card has 98 rupees balance. That balance is coming here. So like that we can access pills using RFID, that is first option. The next option is, so there are one more tube is there. There are IR sensor here. Actually this is for second access, that means first access is RFID and the second access is coin based. In coin based, how it is working? Generally in coin based, if you need only one pill and we are, and you have only the coin, 1 rupee coin, then you have to insert coin into this tube, then it is detected by this this IR sensor, then only after that we have to select the type of pill, whether it is saridone or paracetamol, then based on selection it will come from here or here. So here two kinds of access, one is RFID and one is coin based. In coin based we can't enter multiple. Why? Because in coin based we can drop only one coin at a time. So and also coin means here we are taking 1 rupee coin and each pill is 1 rupee. That's what it is taking 1 rupee for single pill. So this is about the basic operation of this pills dispenser. Now I will show the operation. Initially what we have to do, here we are taking pills like this. So these are like some round kind of pill kind of structure, acrylic. Initially we have to drop these coins from here, and also while dropping a coil from here we have to take care, we have to drop like this. Sometimes what happened, if you are not dropping properly, then it is placing like this. Then if any coin is placed like this, then this mechanism may stuck and it will create some problem. And also we have some facility like this. If there is any pill is stuck inside, so we can move like this. If you move like this, then that pill is coming outside. So here I arranged the mechanism in such a way that we can move these two pills individually from this angle to this angle, then we can take it out easily. So then so this is about the basic how to drop pills into it. And also while dropping pills into it, just for each pill we have to see carefully. So how it is, we have to drop like this and we have to see internally. Better to use any torch, and also how it is placed, whether it is vertical or horizontal. So like that, for each pill we have to carefully observe like this. It is horizontal. With my naked eye I can see, but with this camera I can't see, but mostly it is visible on a horizontal placement. Now I will place few pills here and here. I placed five coins in this tube and five coins in this tube. So totally we have 10 pills separately. So initially now we will see the operation from starting onwards. So here input power, we have to put input power here. After this it is IoT and GSM based. Initially it is initializing IoT module. So for IoT initialization we have to create one hotspot in our mobile with the name of username project 1 and password is project 123. So after that we have to it is initializing GSM. So after switch on this power supply. Then this is reset button. To get GSM signal, it is taking nearly less than 1 minute time. After 1 minute, we have to do reset. Here I did reset. Then on the LCD, it is showing the title pills dispenser. Then it will initialize Wi-Fi module, after that GSM. Here after reset this Arduino Mega, then initially it is checking for initially it is showing connected, that means that is that message related to Wi-Fi. After that means Wi-Fi successfully connected with our hotspot. After that GSM initialized and it is asking send message to store mobile number. So this is for registering our mobile number. Actually, after swiping card and after pills dispensing and all, it has to send that information to one particular number. So which number it has to send, that number we can register. So how to register that mobile number? So I want to get those messages into my mobile number. So that's what we have to type message like this. Star and mobile number, that is my mobile number, and we have to type mobile number like that, and we have to send that star and mobile number message to this SIM, the SIM which is inserted into GSM module. So then send this, then this microcontroller automatically takes that mobile number and it will send mobile number is registered. We can see the message like this, registered. Okay, after that on LCD, so there is one message is coming very fast, that is select option, that is coming like that. Here there are two kinds of modes, one is RFID, one is coin based. Here first I want to show RFID. So there are two RFIDs. I want to show the second RFID card. So on the LCD it is showing card 1 and balance 100 rupees. And after that it is asking enter type, that means type of pill. So here there is keypad is there. So if you press increment button, then it is showing paracetamol. If you press decrement button, it is showing saridone. Enter button is for finalizing saridone or paracetamol. Here I want to go with saridone, that's what I want to press enter button. Okay, here the pill selection completed. After that it is asking enter quantity. We have to enter quantity. So generally here the quantity is in 2 digit, that means first if you want to enter 5 pills or 3 pills, first digit we have to go with 0 and second digit we have to enter 3. So first digit means press like this, on first digit it is showing 0. If I press increment button like this, then it is incrementing. Okay, here I want to make 0, that means I am pressing decrement button. To finalize this, I have to press enter button. I pressed enter button. After enter button, it is we have to press digit for next digit. I'm pressing enter button again, then 3, then enter button. So 3 is finalized. The price is 3 rupees. So then you can see the mechanism like this. Yeah, here we entered 3, that's what 3 pills are came out. In the same way we will see in paracetamol also, we can use same card or other card. So here what happened, after getting these pills we will get the SMS as shown like previous. SMS is came, which type of card we used. We used card 2 and the quantity is 3 and balance is 97. Okay, this is about the message information. So after that, on LCD you will get remaining balance 97. Why? Because we are entering 3 pills, 3 rupees and 3 rupees minus. Then after that one count is coming on the LCD. That count is for here what happened, that information is going to IoT server. Here there is so much of information is going to IoT server. To send any data to IoT server, for each parameter it is taking some time. The time is showing on the LCD. After that again it is select option is coming. Then I want to press, I want to swipe. The first RFID is C1. Then it is asking enter type. Again I want to go with paracetamol. Then enter quantity, I want to enter 4. This is paracetamol section. Here finally I got 4 pills. So here successfully we will get 4 paracetamols and 3 saridan pills. And here the same way we will get SMS also. Paracetamol, card 1, quantity and balance. So here card option completed. And there is in previous video the count is went very fast. Here count is came. This information is coming on IoT. I will show those IoT graphs, how those are visible. Here it is sending which type of card we are using, which type of pill we selected, and how much quantity it has. So here one after another it is sending each parameter. After first parameter sending, the count is coming from 0 to 30 or 35, then again 0 to 35, like that. But for each parameter gap it is showing some LCD blank. Here I want to show IoT graphs. So here initially paracetamol. So in paracetamol how many quantity we selected? 4. So with respect to time all the information is coming. After that here saridan, how many saridan we selected? Now 3. And also which card we are using, whether card 1 or card 2. Card 1. Actually these previous values were, when I checked previously, that is information in previous. Now time is 7:40. Take current information in 7 hour. So I'm using second card also. That's what it is showing. And in card how much balance is remaining, that is here. And also whether we are using coin or not. Currently till now I am not using coin. So coin means, as I told at the starting of this video, only one pill we can dispense. That's what here only one is coming. So this is also when I am checking at 3 o'clock PM. So this information is belongs to not now, but I will show that also. So here we have to take any 1 rupee coin like this. We have to drop from here. Have to drop like this. When we drop the coin from here to here, so it is asking So it is showing enter type. So that means it is detecting coin and it is asking enter type. Then we have to enter, we have to select our coin, whether it is paracetamol or saridon, by using these two. I want to select saridon. Here there is no quantity. Why? Because for single pill, for single pill only one is coming. Yeah. After selecting coin, we have to press enter button. So after that only one is coming. So then on LCD it is showing pill out. For each pill it is showing pill out. Then information is coming to saridon. And it is coin type, there is no card, and the quantity is 1. So that's what, there is no remaining balance and all, this information is coming here. So the same information is going to server. On IoT you can see, so for coin, the previous information is at 3 o'clock, there in just 1 minute back it is at only single dot. But now it is double dot, that means current value is also came 745. Okay, this is about pills dispenser. And also while dropping coin from here, so we have to make sure that it should be in a vertical position. Okay, this is about complete thing about pills dispenser. And also finally, the main, how this mechanism is working. So in this two structures maintain without any gap. So while doing any experiments or anything, if there is any air gap in between these two, maybe there may be pill is striking here, and that kind of problems may occur. Just handle very carefully and very sensitively, and we have to maintain the distances like this. Anyway, this is entirely fixed with very strong screws and glues. Okay.